5 years or is a very long time as a leader of a political party, as a leader that takes on the role as Deputy Premier. And as the role in Deputy Premier, I've taken that seriously and I've given it everything I possibly could have. For all of you, you know I wear my heart on my sleeve. I fight each and every day for what I believe in, and I genuinely do it because I care about the role and the people of New South Wales, and it's been an absolute privilege. I wish, of course, the Liberal Party in their deliberations about their next leader, and as we saw yesterday, no doubt, it looks like Dominic Perrottet, someone I call a friend, someone I know, that will take this state right now at a time that it needs strong leadership through the opening up, the end of the pandemic, the start of the recovery. And I genuinely believe in his role as Treasurer, he has all the skills and all the ability, and if endorsed as the leader of the Liberal Party, Premier of this state, he'll do a wonderful job. It has been an incredible journey, one that you can't just put in grabs or in words in front of a camera. But can I say I have enjoyed every single day of it? But it has taken a toll. It is tough on anybody in public life to continue in this role, especially under so much scrutiny, especially media scrutiny. And that's good. That's great for democracy. It's great for transparency. But it also means that for many of us, we do think about when we end our journey. Even in these recent months and over the past 12 months especially, the very public defamation case that I have going at the moment, unbelievable, you know, that I have to defend myself from vile and racist attacks in a social setting, in a social media setting, by individuals. And you know, a $1 trillion company like Google allow that sort of vile racial attack on any individual, regardless of public figure or not, to remain is something that I can't believe in 2021 still exists. As a young boy of migrant parents, I grew up, I understood what racism was, called many of those names. I didn't think in 2021 that'll continue. And that in itself, can I say, was very difficult this year. And to be able to defend myself and continue with that case, I prefer to do it privately, not in the public eye. And that's been a big reason for today's announcement, along with the opportunity that has now opened, that maybe now is the refresh. I have to be honest, what occurred on Friday, it hasn't played any part in the decision that I've made. The reality, and many of you guys have been pushing me, and I've unfortunately not been able to be honest with you, but I've been thinking about this for a while. I had another date picked in mind, not too far off, but I just think with the opportunities that have now arisen, and it'd be unfair that at some point this week under Dominic Perrottet as Premier, he'll be swearing in a new cabinet. It'd be just unfair and not right to go down the Government House, to get sworn in, and only weeks later to step aside.